step friends. Gonna listen to a little mini Ripperton as people come in. Hello, hello. We're just gonna do a little breathing and a little movement. Hi. Today, and I'm stoked to be here with you for this mindful moment. Hi Brian, hi Shiny. Oh my goodness. Wow. Hello, hello. I'm so happy that everybody's here. My goodness. Lots of love back to SB. Yes. Hi Lizzie. So as people are sort of shuffling in and out, I wanted to share something that Rachel Cargill, who's an anti-racist teacher, among many other things, just reshared, I think, like 12 hours ago. And it feels like a really timely thing. I'm grateful to get to share it here. So I'll read a little bit about that, and then we can jump into some breath work. Yeah, so good to see everybody here. I'm so thrilled to be doing this. Okay, so this is from Rachel Cargill. It was actually posted originally in 2017, which is a long time ago, but still obviously needs to be repeated. So. Let's see. Wellness is being commodified. The good vibes and self-love and goddess groups are making cash off of people's direct experiences in a system that was built and is being maintained to promote systems like patriarchy, racism, misogyny, and poverty. I don't want your love and light if you're not also doing the work to make the world we live in a more survivable place for me and for those less vulnerable. There is a crucial self-care and social justice component to our collective wellness. Meditate and call your senator. Go to yoga and go vote. Breathe deeply and donate to causes that matter. And she goes on and on. So I think this is really important in this moment as we get ready to like move and breathe together for wellness. That we are also doing a lot of other things to dismantle the systems that are sort of inherent within wellness right now. Hi, everybody. Yeah, so if you're consuming resources from Rachel Cargill, I highly recommend paying her via Patreon monthly and continuing to do that learning. So, all right. I am going to begin with some breath work, and I learned this in India. It's like a basic pranayama practice, and I was grateful to get to study a little bit of that after I taught at Shanti Bhavan in India with A-Step, so this most recent time. So if you are joining me, just take a kneel. If that's bothering you, you can sit cross-legged, however feels best for you. Just closing your eyes, your palms can lay on top of your thighs. Just sort of connecting to your breath here, allowing it to be whatever it is in this moment. Now you're gonna place your palms on your belly, which I don't believe you can see, but sort of on either side of your belly button. And we're gonna do two breath cycles, really thinking about expanding through your belly. So an inhale through your nose, exhale through your mouth, belly button to spine. Inhale through your nose. Exhale through your mouth, belly button to spine. Palms go back to your thighs. One breath cycle to cleanse. Now bringing your hands to your rib cage, thinking about expansion here now, you're gonna hook your thumbs underneath your armpits and wrap the rest of your fingers around the front of your chest. Same thing, two breath cycles, thinking about expanding through your chest here. One more like that. One to cleanse, palms go back onto the tops of your thighs. You'll notice your belly and your ribcage start to connect there. Adding that final component, we are going to think about our throat now. So our palms are going to the back of your neck. You can interlace your fingers behind your neck, creating a little cradle. You're thinking about your throat chakra here, and breathing into that space. So another inhale, two breath cycles. Inhale through your nose. Thinking about that throat here. And palms back to where they started on your thighs. A few breath cycles, thinking about your belly, your rib cage, and your throat chakra as one bright canal all the way through your body, feeling your breath fill that space. Fluttering your eyes open. We are going to jump into a little bit of free movement here. Let's get some tunes going. Definitely can't move freely, in my opinion, if you don't have some music to do it to. So as you can see, I'm here in my room. I don't have a whole lot of space, and lots of people are in that position right now, so we're gonna work with what we have. Feeling your feet planted firmly on the ground. Maybe you rock back and forth in your hips. Start to feel where your weight can be even between your feet. And once you find that equilibrium, bending your knees slightly, reaching up to the sky with an inhale. And bringing that to a flat back and releasing down, hanging over your legs. I'm gonna make sure you can see. Looks like you can. Rolling up through the spine. One more time, a big inhale. Flat back down with your exhale, hanging over. Continuing to rock through your hips here. And rolling back up through your spine, taking a wider stance. Another inhale, exhale, arms reach up with an inhale, carve through the space, exhale. Inhale, carve through the space, exhale. This is your last one here. Coming down to plant your palms down on the floor and walking out to a plank. This might be a little tough, depending on where you are. But thinking about length here, imagining that through the backs of your heels and out the top of your head, all the way through your spine, that there is one long, tall ray of sunshine. Activating our imagination here to make the movement as therapeutic as possible. We are starting to build some heat. So as we do, imagining that ray of sunshine just glowing stronger and stronger as we hold. Five more seconds. It's five, four, three, two, pushing back to a downward dog here. Maybe you pedal out through your heels. Maybe you shake your head yes and no. Are you breathing? Maybe make some sound. Thinking about stretching through your heels and allowing your back body, your hamstrings, to become nice and long. Thinking about a plant, a flower blooming in the back body. To make space here. Now bending both knees and slowly walking your feet in towards your hands. Coming back to that hangover. We're gonna test our weight by putting our full weight on our left, test our balance rather, putting our full weight on our left foot. Coming back to center, test your balance, weight over on the right. We're also creating space in the lower back here. All right, this song is coming to an end, so relaxing over, rolling up through your spine, nice and tall. Bill Withers, rest in peace, Bill Withers, we love you. You gotta have a little lovely day. It's the best song to move to, in my opinion. All right, so join me in a wide second position. Coming to a grand plié second, if you're not a dancer, it's a wide stance. This can also be called a sumo squat. Your knees are over your toes here. Bringing your hands to a prayer and starting a pulse down. Okay. So right here, I want you to think about building strength in your lower body as you start to create some freedom and breath in the upper body. So maybe that looks like a head roll as you continue that pulse. Maybe that looks like painting with your upper body. Whatever it is, think about your breath, allowing some, see something. Oh yes, quarantine warm-up song. It's the best, it's the absolute best. So here we are. We're gonna freeze here. Think about pushing something into a lunge on this side. Slow motion back to center. Other side pushes all the way to this lunge, rotating to your side. We're gonna do this a little faster. Ready? It's push, center, whoo. What are you pushing away here, right? In order to make this movement therapeutic, we are using our own resistance and our own imaginations to think about, what am I trying to get rid of? What am I trying to harness? Whew. Two more here. It goes one side to the other side. Freeze here, coming back, your feet directly under your hips, raising those heels into a nice tall releve and lowering them a little faster. Up, down, down. I'm out of breath. Okay, so when we start to get this way, coming back to that breath that we started with at the beginning. And now, as we start to build heat in our calves, can you extend your hands and then bring them into fists? Like light bulbs blinking on and off. Maybe you want to go in a circle here. Maybe it feels better to do some other version, other shapes that you're making here. It's up to you. Free movement here. I'm regretting not having my air conditioner on for the sake of sound, because now I'm sweating. Whew. Four more here. Four, three, two, one. Coming into a chair pose. So a nice long line again, out through your spine, out through the top of your head. We are finishing here this song. Yeah, building more heat in that lower body. Maybe we press back to engage your triceps. Up overhead, back, up overhead. We're almost done. We have one last song to cool down. Keep going here. What do you want to get out of this? Quick little bit of movement. Last one. Extend and rolling your shoulders back. Maybe you get a head roll here. Ah, nice. We have about 2 minutes left together. Coming to your hands and knees. Let's see, can you see me here? Looks like it. Anything I need to pay attention to? I don't think so. Joining me on your hands and your knees. Taking a free form cat-cow here. Releasing the belly. Oh. Coming to your cat. Oh. Belly button is fine. Length, space. That's fine. Maybe you take some circles here. Right? Maybe that feels good. Oh, my neck feels particularly tight right now. That's where I'm gonna focus my attention. Oh. Let's see. Taking your right hand, threading it underneath your left in the space between, and finding a stretch here. I hope that you can see me. This is a thread the needle. Maybe you take your left arm up to the sky. We warmed up that rib cage with some breath in the beginning, and this is a nice additional twist. One more breath here. Planting your left hand and switching. Left hand goes underneath, threading the needle. Maybe your right arm comes up to the sky. Feeling that twist. And finishing off with a child's pose here. Your forehead to the ground. Just listen to my voice here as you're in your child's pose. I'm gonna turn this music off. Your third eye, the space directly in between your eyeballs, is planting firmly onto the ground. Allowing that natural wisdom to grow as you create that pressure against the floor, rooting it down into the earth. One more inhale and exhale in your child's pose. Maybe you release some sound on that one. Nice. Sitting back up. And I think that's it. I'm making sure I didn't miss anything here. No, thanks so much for joining me. And I think this will be up on A-Step's Instagram in case you want to do any of it on another day. So I hope you have a great rest of your day and week, and thanks for joining me.